Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected brothers and sisters in America and elsewhere in the world. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa man wala amma ba'd. All praise are for Allah. May peace and blessings of Allah descend upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Shafi is at home, like any other person being at home. And of course, this is one of the safety measures. This is one of the precautious measures that Islam promotes. And of course, as announced by the government, right from White House and coming down to the state governor and mayors, that people should be staying at home to help, should I say, contain, to help curb, to help minimize the harm of coronavirus. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. What we should understand, my brothers, is that this is not a punishment for us believers. This is not adab. This is rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that wallahu ja'ala lakum min buyutikum sakana. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made for you your homes as places of rest, as places where you can find peace, you can find harmony, you can find tranquility. So Allah Azza wa Jalla is mentioning that. And not only that, having a home, having a house is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I can just imagine that a day like this, if I were not sick, I would have not been here. And I'm referring to my normal days. Because if today is Wednesday, then Wednesday I should have led Salatul Maghrib, and then I should have, have been teaching, or I should have waited for Isha. Like, I'm home, and you have just seen my daughter, my last one for now, okay, being with me here. And this is a proof that she is at home. For subhanallah, this is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he brought us home to revive Ibaadah to home, to revive such acts of worship which are meant to be at home. A mu'min, a believer, is always happy with all situations. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made it clear, giving hope, when he said that ajaban li amri al-mu'min, inna amrahu kullahu khayr, wa la yakunu dhalika aw wa laysa dhalika illa li-mu'min. That how amazing, how beautiful, how wonderful are the affairs of a mu'min, of a believer. Inna amrahu kullahu khayr, for all his or her affairs is khair. There is good in all believers' affairs. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reminding us. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is awakening us. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is informing us that no matter how tough or no matter how beautiful your situation is, you should still think good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good situation or bad should help you to keep your hopes alive. How beautiful and how amazing, how wonderful is your affair who is watching this and those who do not watch this, how beautiful, how good, how better are the affairs and matters of a believer. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said, in asabatuhu sarra'u shakara fakana khayran lah. That when he is going through good time, when everything appears to be normal to him, he's not sick, he's not, you know, going through hardships, whether financial, whether mental. I say what appears to you to be good, when you are going through good, you are not stressed, you are not distressed, you are not depressed, you don't go through anxieties, you don't go through any fear, right? Shakara. A Muslim, a mu'min has to be grateful to Allah and thankful to Allah. فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. Then it is good for him or her. So you should always remember to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding all ni'am, all blessings and favors which he has bestowed upon you. All ni'am, all blessings that you cannot count. Because there are ni'am which are zahiran. There are ni'am which can be seen. They are apparent wa batina. And there are many, many blessings and favors of Allah that you will never see. طيب وإن أصابته الضراء صبرا. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم also says that when a Muslim, when a mu'min is afflicted by any hardship, when a Muslim is going through adversity, hardship, sicknesses, fear, right? Misfortunes, tribulations, big tests and trials, sabara, he or she doesn't give up. He or she doesn't lose hope. He and she doesn't blame the situation. He and she does not blame it on everybody, on others. You don't just cry and cry and say, I don't know what is happening with me. Why me? Why me? That is not part of Iman. Sabara. Sabara. You have to be patient. And brothers and sisters, the ajr of sabr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, innama yuwaffa as-sabiruna ajrahum bighayri hisab. He said that verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, he will reward as-sabirun, those who are patient, those who persevered, those who are tolerant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them without yani limit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will yani without, because the reward is so great, and this quality of patience is so great, and for you to ascend and to be promoted, even to be included among those who are patient, you must have really worked very hard. لذلك رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم say that when you are going through hardships, when you are going through things that does not please you, because a human being is a little bit weak. We tend to love, you know, soft part of life. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you, He tries you with both good and bad. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, and He tests you with good and bad. Anything that you perceive as good and anything that you perceive as evil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you with it. He says that He will try you with that. So you have to be patient when going through hardships, and you have to be yani thankful and grateful to Allah, especially at these moments of coronavirus. Coronavirus comes with a lot. It comes with the economic constraints. It comes with some physical restrictions. It comes with the psychological and even mental. Many people are depressed. In fact, some people don't even know how they're going to pay for their rents. Some people don't even know how they're going to, you know, have food at human level. Now the hope is this: be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also be patient, combined between gratefulness and patience, and keep your hope alive, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wallahu yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. Wallahu yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sustains whoever He wills, bighayri hisab, without even imagining, without imagination. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani provides not only you, He provides a snake, He provides a tree, He provides, you know, for this land, He provides living and non-living things. He is Ar-Razaq. Keep believing Him, keep hoping yani in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trust in Him, do not give up, be thankful to Allah, and also be patient, and yani be consistent in dhikr and istighfar, and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then leave the rest in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He promises that وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whosoever fears Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make for him an exit from every trouble. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And Allah will provide for him or her from the sources that he would have not even have imagined. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whosoever put his trust in Allah or had trust in Allah, Allah suffices for him. Inna Allaha balighu amri, qad ja'ala Allahu li kulli shay'in qadra. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yani help us to remember Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to thank Him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in this situation of being at home to worship Him in the best way that pleases Him, as He commanded, and also as He loves, in the light of Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We love you all. Again, I'm at home, alhamdulillah. I'm a happy man, and I hope that you will also be happy men and women and children. And please, let us help our men. Let us help our wives at home. Wash plates, change diapers, right? And, you know, you can also mop your floor. There's no problem with that. Wash clothes. This is the best time that you can spend with your wife and your children. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do all that. He was the best in domestic what? Not domestic violence. He was best in domestic work, in helping his wife, as mentioned by Aisha radiallahu anha. Sisters, don't get tired of us men when we are home, right? Please receive us home. Help us make your homes comfortable for your husbands, right? Somebody said, it was on Facebook, when a mayor said that, you know, people should stay at home because of coronavirus. This person said, no, of course, he just wrote on something on Facebook. He said, I don't think if I'm going to obey, you know, this order, because my wife at home is worse than coronavirus. So please, that should not happen. Men, don't be coronavirus at home. And also wives, don't be coronavirus at home. Let us promote love. Let us, you know, create an Islamic home. Let us Islamize our lives at home. And let us, you know, aim very high. And what is high? Dua. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْلَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. So you're asking Allah to make your wife to be the happiness of your heart and your eyes and your children. And your wife is also making dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you, the husband, to be the happiness and joy of her heart and her eyes and your children. And then together you say, وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا, and make us as a family to be the leaders of the pious. Jazakumullahu khair. Don't forget to make dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dua against corona, dua against AIDS, dua against Ebola, and many other viruses and many other evil diseases. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, he used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-baras wal-junoon wal-judham wa sayyi'il asqam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Please meet you in the future episode. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.